Hi everyone, Aaron here for zollotech, and today Apple released iOS 12.3 Beta 6. This is available to developers and public beta testers, and came in at a pretty small 83.2 megabytes on my iPhone XR. Now that size could vary for you depending on which device you're on. It could be a little bit more or less, it just depends. But let's take a look at the build number. Now you can see the build is 16F5156A, and this particular build is getting very close to the final release. There's actually nothing new in the notes for the developer notes. There's also nothing new that we can find anyway as far as the overall interface or changes anywhere. There may be tiny font changes or things like that, but even the modem number or the modem firmware and also the carrier settings seem to be all the same, although they are tweaking them here and there. So there isn't really anything on the surface that looks new, nothing like that, just behind the scenes bug fixes getting it ready for public release. And we should see that public release on maybe next week or the week after, and or maybe even at the end of the month, since we're getting ready for the iOS 12.3 TV update. That's really what this update is all about. This TV app here that I have on the iPad, where you can subscribe to different services. So you can subscribe to HBO, Showtime, Cinemax, Stars, whatever you'd like, and more services will be added to that, and more countries as well. Now, as far as anything else new in this, don't really expect anything new at all until we get to iOS 13, which comes out in the beginning of June, at least for beta testers, and then later in the year in September. In September, it will be available to everyone, usually when the new iPhones come out. Now, this particular build, the last build was okay. Battery life was not phenomenal, but it was okay. If we take a look at the battery life on this device, I have 100%, and you'll see here we have, at my best day anyway, 5 hours and 5 minutes screen on time, 2 hours and 51 minutes of screen off time. That was using Twitter, Spark, Tesla, Gmail, and a few other apps. I used it pretty heavily that day, and at the end of the day, I only had about 20% battery life left. Now, so far, Beta 6 seems to be nice and smooth. In fact, I've tried it on the older devices, such as the SE here. The SE scrolling is nice and smooth. I haven't had any lockups in settings. I know that was an issue for some people. In previous builds, it seems like it's working okay there. If we go into something like music, you'll see it's nice and fast and fluid. Even on the iPhone 6S Plus, which is around the same sort of era, it is about the same. So scrolling is nice and smooth. Rotation is fine. If you have one of the Plus devices and can use landscape, everything works well. 3D touch is working just fine. And you'll see apps are pretty fast overall. They load pretty quickly. I haven't had any issues. In fact, I think they've really improved speed with this particular update, and that's the main fix, I think. So I would expect bug fixes, maybe some security fixes in the background, and nothing spectacular. So we will see that. Hopefully in a couple of weeks, we'll have the final release, and then in the beginning of June, we'll see iOS 13. Now, I did run a Geekbench on all of these just to give you a reference. Let's take a look at the XS Max first, and we'll go to our benchmarks. And you'll see single core was 4,778, whereas multi-core was 11,162. The history, if we take a look at that, it's about the same. So as long as we're close to the other numbers, everything should be pretty fast and fluid. It's definitely much better than the earlier builds down here, where we were in the 10,000s for the multi-core benchmark scores. Let me set up the others so you can get a quick reference as to what the other devices are. So here's a look at the iPad Pro Geekbench scores, the iPhone 6S Plus, the iPhone XR, the iPhone SE, and the XS Max. So that should give you an idea of what yours should be near or close to. Now, aside from all of the other information, there was some rumors that the iPhone SE may not be included with iOS 13. And I find that to be kind of strange. I would expect that anything from the SE to the 6S, 6S Plus to be in iOS 13's included supported library of devices. But it seems that some rumors are saying it may not be. I have a hard time believing that, but we'll only know that for sure in June when we have more information at WWDC. So let me know what you think in the comments below. Of course, I'll link this wallpaper in the description as I always do. If you haven't subscribed already though, please subscribe and give the video a like if you enjoyed it. If not, the other one's okay too. As always, thanks for watching. This is Aaron. I'll see you next time.